Hello once again, everybody. I'm Jeff. Welcome to the Gridiron. This week, I want to take a look back at the year of 1960 just happened to be the 41st regular season in the history of the National Football League. And 1960 just happened to be one of the, if not the most important years in all of professional football. 1960, it was the NFL and the newly formed AFL, or American Football League. American Football League consisted of 8 teams, which, well, at the time was 8 teams. By the 1969 season, they would have 10 teams in the league. And the following year, 1970, the American Football League and the National Football League were combined to make one big league. But the American Football League started off in 1960 with 8 teams. And those 8 teams were in the Eastern Division of the American Football League. There was the Houston Oilers, the Buffalo Bills, the Boston Patriots, and the New York Titans. The New York Titans would, in 1963, change their names to the New York Jets. The Western Division of the American Football League consisted of the Oakland Raiders, the Denver Broncos, the Los Angeles Chargers, who the following year would turn out to be the San Diego Chargers, and the fourth team was the Dallas Texans, who in 1963 would become the Kansas City Chiefs. In the American Football League, the Houston Oilers would win the Eastern Division with a record of 10-4. And likewise, the Los Angeles Chargers would win the Western Division with a record of 10-4. And they would meet each other in the first American Football League championship game. The first American Football League championship game was played on January 1st, 1961, in Houston, in front of a crowd of over 30,000 people. And the Houston Oilers would not disappoint. They would beat the Los Angeles Chargers by a score of 24-16. Now, over in the National Football League, there was the Eastern Conference and there was the Western Conference. It was the Dallas Cowboys became an expansion team. It was in the prior 1959 season, there was only 12 teams with the inclusion of the Dallas Cowboys in the 1960 season. There was 13 teams in the National Football League. The Eastern Conference had 6 teams. The Western Conference had 7 teams. The following year, 1961, the Minnesota Vikings would join the NFL, pushing the Dallas Cowboys from the Western Conference over into the Eastern Conference, and the Minnesota would take their spot in the Western Conference, giving each conference 7 teams. But as of 1960, there were 6 teams in the Eastern Conference and 7 in the Western Conference. The Eastern Conference consisted of the St. Louis Cardinals, the Pittsburgh Steelers, the Washington Redskins, the New York Giants, the Cleveland Browns, and the Philadelphia Eagles. The Western Conference consisted of the Green Bay Packers, the Chicago Bears, the Detroit Lions, the Baltimore Colts, the Dallas Cowboys, the Los Angeles Rams, and the San Francisco 49ers. All teams in the NFL played a 12-game schedule in 1960. The following season, 1961, the NFL would adopt a 14-game schedule. Now over in the Eastern Conference, after an opening day loss, the Philadelphia Eagles lost to the Cleveland Browns 41-24. The Philadelphia Eagles would run off a string of 9 consecutive victories. And by the time they lost to the Pittsburgh Steelers in week 11 by a score of 27-21, the Eagles all but had the Eastern Conference wrapped up. They would finish the season with a record of 10 wins and 2 losses, sending them into the NFL Championship game 1960. Over in the Western Conference, in only his second season as the head coach of the Green Bay Packers, Vince Lombardi would lead the Packers to the Western Conference Championship with a record of 8 wins and 4 losses. To do so, they had to win the final 3 games of the regular season, and they became the first time that they won the Western Conference since 1944. The 1960 NFL Championship game was played between Philadelphia Eagles, Green Bay Packers in Philadelphia on the day after Christmas, December 26th, 1960, in front of a crowd of over 67,000 people. The Packers would get the initial break of the game, recovering the Eagles' fumble on the Philadelphia 14-yard line on the first play from scrimmage. However, Green Bay, after recovering the fumble, would run the ball four times and only gain 9 yards, thus turning the ball over on downs. The Eagles, once they got the ball, three plays later, they would fumble the ball again. The Packers would recover once again on the Eagles' 22-yard line. Packers would have to settle for a Paul Hornung field goal to make the score Green Bay 3, Eagles nothing in the first quarter. And just a little side note here, 1960, Paul Hornung set an NFL record, since broken, of 176 points he scored during the 1960 season. Now, just making this remarkable is that he only did it in 12 games. Since then, it's been broken, but it was broken in a 16-game schedule. If Paul Hornung had, he averaged almost 15 points a game. Paul Hornung played an additional 4 games. He would have gotten anywhere from another, at the rate he was going, another 50 to 60 points. So that means he would have scored in a 16-game schedule anywhere from 220 to 235 points. Absolutely remarkable. Phenomenal season for Paul Hornung. Early in the second quarter, Paul Hornung would once again strike for the Green Bay Packers, kicking another field goal to extend the Packers' lead to 6-0. However, halfway through the second quarter, two Hall of Famers would hook up. Norm Van Brocken would complete a 35-yard touchdown pass to Tommy McDonald, giving the Eagles a 7-6 lead. And just a few minutes before halftime, the Eagles would extend their lead to 10-6 on a 15-yard field goal. There was no scoring in the third quarter. However, just a couple minutes into the fourth quarter, Bart Starr would hit Max McGee on a touchdown pass, capping off an 80-yard drive to give the Green Bay Packers a 13-10 lead. On the ensuing kickoff, Ted Dean would return the ball to the Green Bay Packers' 39-yard line, giving the Eagles outstanding field position. 7 plays later, Dean would run the ball over from the 5-yard line, giving the Eagles a 17-13 lead. The Green Bay Packers would respond toward the end of the game. They would drive down to the Eagles' 9-yard line, but that is where time would run out on them as Bart Starr dropped back the pass, would hit Jim Taylor kind of over the middle for a very short pass, and that's where concrete Chuck Bednarik clamped down on the Hall of Fame running back, Jim Taylor, preventing him from going any further, tackled him at the 9. Kind of held him there, clock ran out, game was over, giving the Eagles the 1960 NFL Championship by a score of 17-13. It would also be Vince Lombardi's only postseason game loss. You got to look at it like, you can see how times were different. I mean, right now, coaches would probably get fired or heads would roll or something if you're dropping back the pass, you only had time, basically you had no timeouts left, and you try to dig a pass over the middle, and you either gotta go for the end zone, or you gotta go where the guy can get out of bounds. So it just shows you how time changed. Back then, 50 years ago, you throw the ball to a Hall of Fame running back, and he was just kind of hoping he would just plow his way into the end zone, but it was not meant to be. To the Eagles, fantastic season. To the Green Bay Packers, well, this was your championship loss, but over the next several years, you would win 5 NFL championships in a 7-year span. Well, that's all the time I have for this week. 1 year, we're going to bet the next week. Well, you have to come back and see that, won't you? I'm Jeff. Thanks for watching. Remember, I'm going to see you on the gridiron.